Ideally, you'll do inlet maintenance according to a regular schedule and avoid instrument downtime and sample rework. Deciding on a schedule depends on a few factors. These include how many samples you run, the type of samples you run, and how critical are the results. A QA lab that runs hundreds of relatively dirty samples a day might have a schedule for replacing the septum and liner daily, the gold sealed weekly, and the split vent trap every 3 months. In the other extreme, a lab running only a few clean samples a day might replace the septum weekly and the liner once a month. Whatever your schedule is, the consumables need to be replaced before they quit protecting your GC. Replace the septum before it has an air leak and damages your column. Replace the liner and gold seal before dirt builds up and that causes contamination peaks. Replace the split vent trap before dirt gets into the split vent valve or causes a shift in retention time or area counts. The starting point for any of the inlet maintenance procedure is to create a method that protects your GC column. Essentially, you want to cool the inlet and the oven and depressurize the inlet. First, let's create a copy of an analytical method for this instrument and change the name to include IM for inlet maintenance. Under the instrument parameters, let's set the oven temperature to about 40 degrees. And apply. And let's set the inlet temperature to off and the pressure to zero. If we were going to work on the column or the detector, we'd change the detector settings also. Now, we'll save the method. Next time we do inlet maintenance, we can simply load this method and wait until the GC comes ready.